This month's Japanese history focuses on the Meiji Restoration, as we did last time. The Meiji Restoration was a movement against the shogunate and modernization reforms that took place at the end of the Edo period. This revolution made Japan one of the few countries that did not become a colony of the Western powers, and had a strong influence on the rest of Asia. In the previous article, we looked at the movements of the Edo shogunate and the imperial court, the government of the day. In this article, we will look at the Choshu clan, which played a leading role in Sunojoy movement to expel Westerners. Surprisingly, it was Nagai Gagaku's voyage to the Far East, which advocated the opening of Japan to the outside world, rather than the expulsion of the barbarians, that had the greatest impact on the Choshu clan. The idea was to open the country to the West, absorb and adopt Western civilization to boost Japan's national strength, and then use that strength to launch Japan into the world. This was exactly what the Meiji government was pushing for in its policy of enriching and strengthening the nation. In short, it seems to have been a very realistic and good idea. However, Nagai's campaign ended in failure. The Choshu clan submitted Nagai's proposal to the shogunate and the imperial court as the clan's written confession. It was an unprecedented event for a retainer of a foreign feudal lord to meet with important people of the shogunate and the imperial court, but the shogunate initially welcomed this proposal as it was very advantageous for the opening of the country. The imperial court expressed the same opinion. However, while Nagai was in Kyoto to work on the project, the atmosphere in the Choshu domain had changed dramatically. Genzuku Sakya, Kogoro Katsura, and other militant expulsionists insisted on expulsion of the foreigners and were opposed to opening the country to the outside world. They were also very unhappy with Nagai's refusal to question the shogunate's execution of his mentor, Shoin Yoshida. In Nagai's absence, Kusaka and his followers had been able to rally the clan around the cause of expulsion of the foreigners, and the lord of the Choshu clan had become frightened and switched the clan's position to that of expulsion of the foreigners. In addition, key figures in the shogunate who had favored Nagai's position were forced to leave their posts, and the Satsuma lord Hisamitsu Shimazu led his troops to Tokyo. Nagai's efforts were unsuccessful. Nagai was also forced out of his post and ordered to commit seppuku, ritual suicide, after being accused of slander by Kusaka and others. If Nagai's plan had been successful, history might have been very different. After Nagai's downfall, the radicalization of the Choshu clan proceeded. At this time, Choshu was playing a leadership role in the imperial court with Satsuma. Shimazu Hisamitsu of the Satsuma clan led his troops to Kyoto. Shimazu Hisamitsu's goal was to obtain the imperial court's approval for political reforms to be implemented by the shogunate. However, many samurai from across the country gathered in Kyoto, believing that Satsuma was planning to lead his troops to expel the barbarians and defeat the shogunate. As more and more of these bloodthirsty samurai arrived in Kyoto, the city's security situation deteriorated rapidly. In response to this situation, the shogunate ordered Matsudaira no Yoho of Aizu to guard Kyoto. At this time, the famous Shinsengumi was established. I will explain more about the Shinsengumi in another video. In response to this move by Satsuma, Choshu worked with the court nobles to get the emperor to immediately issue an imperial decree to expel the barbarians. With Choshu on their side, hardline expulsionists such as Sanjo Sanami and Ayano Koji Kauchi actively urged the shogunate to expel the barbarians. The shogunate had promised to expel the barbarians when the shogun Ishige married the emperor's sister, Wamiya, and was very troubled by the imperial court's demands. Even those in the shogunate who were unfamiliar with international politics knew that once a treaty had been signed with a foreign country, it would be extremely difficult to break it, and when he assumed the shogun's post, Yoshinobu Hitotsubashi tried to stall the imperial court's request to expel the barbarians as long as possible. In response, the Choshu clan, as a precursor to the expulsion of the barbarians, opened fire on foreign ships in Shimonoseki, their port. While the shogunate remained ambiguous about the date of the expulsion of the barbarians, the Choshu clan planned to expel the expulsion of the barbarians with a group of samurai, mostly from the Choshu clan, at the behest of the imperial court. Emperor Komei was not a fan of foreign nations, but he was even more averse to radical nobles and the Choshu clan. He also did not want the imperial court to fight the expulsion of the barbarians. Hisamitsu Shimazu of Satsuma came to Kyoto and was determined to reform the shogunate, but things did not go well and he returned to Satsuma. The emperor relied on the moderate Satsuma clan more than the Choshu clan, and requested Hisamitsu Shimazu to come to Kyoto again. The Choshu clan had been making arrangements for the expulsion of the barbarians within the imperial court and formally asked the court to issue an imperial order for the Choshu clan and others to fight the expulsion of the barbarians. The emperor was troubled and asked the Satsuma clan to come to Kyoto under the guise of joining the expulsion of the barbarians. However, the emperor's real goal was for the Satsuma clan to defeat the Choshu clan. The Choshu clan did not intend to wage war against foreign nations on its own, but rather to join forces with several other clans that favored expulsion of the barbarians. As the Choshu clan became increasingly isolated, it grew impatient. They asked the emperor to visit the Ise Shrine to pray for the success of the expulsion of the barbarians. This was not the emperor's intention at all, and he was so exhausted that he could hardly finish his meals. There were also rumors circulating that the emperor was going to burn down Kyoto and take the emperor to Choshu while he was on his way to Ise, and that he was going to conquer the foreigner quarter in Yokohama. The situation was developing rapidly, and the Satsuma samurai in Kyoto, whose lord had yet to come to Kyoto, were growing impatient. They knew that they had to stop the Choshu clan from going it alone in order to break the situation. With few troops in Kyoto, the Satsuma asked for help from the Aizu clan, which was the guardian of Kyoto. The Satsuma and Aizu presented the emperor with a plan to eliminate the Choshu clan's influence in the imperial court. The emperor readily agreed, and the plan was carried out. The soldiers, mainly from the Satsuma and Aizu clans, blocked all the gates of the Kyoto Imperial Palace, forcing the other lords of the clans living in Kyoto to enter the palace, postponing the emperor's visit, and placing under house arrest Sanami Sanjo and other noblemen who had joined the Choshu clan. The samurai of the Choshu clan, who had few troops, continued to stare down the samurai of the Satsuma and Aizu clans at the gate of the imperial palace, and then left for Choshu. Sanami Sanjo and other militant nobles were forced to flee to Choshu with the Choshu samurai. This political uprising was called the Political Uprising of August 18. Thus, the Choshu domain lost its influence in the imperial court. The militant expulsion of the barbarians by the Choshu clan had disappeared, and the court was dominated by the Shimazu family and other influential feudal lords who were advocates of a combined government and military force. Basically, the imperial court was an expulsionist. The imperial court again urged the shogunate to expel the barbarians. However, the shogunate knew that the expulsion of the barbarians was unfeasible, and they wanted to settle the issue by closing the port of Yokohama, which had already been opened. However, the issue of the port of Yokohama led to a fierce rivalry between Yoshinobu Hitotsubashi and Hisamitsu Shimazu, and the politics of the various princes reached an impasse. In response to this situation, advocates of expulsion of the barbarians in various parts of the country began to look forward to the return of the Shushu clan to the stage. The Choshu clan, for its part, began to argue that it should use force to come to Kyoto and restore its honor. The ringleaders of this argument were Mitabe Kuroshima and others. Kogoro Katsura, Shinsako Takasugi, and Genzu Kusakya, who were more cautious, urged them to act with caution. It was then that the Acadia incident occurred. On July 4, 1864, the Shinsengumi discovered that the expulsionists, mainly from the Choshu domain, were planning to burn down Kyoto, kill Yoshinobu Itatsubashi and Katamori Matsudaira, and take the emperor to Choshu. It is important to note that it is noteworthy that four members of the Shinsengumi, including Osamu Kondo and Soji Okita, attacked more than 20 samurai. How daring! The battle quickly turned into a slugfest, and Toshiso Hijikata and his men soon joined in, cutting down 9 of the expulsionists and capturing 4 of them. This incident brought the Shinsengumi to prominence. This incident, in which a Choshu samurai was killed, infuriated the Choshu clan. Kurashima and others decided to raise an army to appeal to the emperor for the false accusations against the feudal lord. Shinsako Takasugi and others tried desperately to pacify them, but they could not stop them. When the imperial court heard of the Choshu's campaign, it was in turmoil, and some nobles and others wanted to forgive the Choshu. On July 17, the Choshu, Aizu, and Kuuna clans fought at the forbidden gate of the Kyoto Imperial Palace. Initially, the Choshu clan had the upper hand in the battle, but when the Satsuma clan led by Takamori Saigo and others joined the Aizu clan, the situation quickly reversed. Mitabe Kurashima was killed in battle, and Genzu Kusaka committed suicide. Genzu Kusaka, who was recognized by Shoin Yoshida as the most talented of his disciples, was a young man of 25 years. Thus, the young men of Choshu who led the Meiji Restoration were all still in their 20s. This incident is called the Forbidden Gate Incident. By drawing bows and arrows against the imperial court, the Choshu domain became an enemy of the imperial court, and the shogunate sent troops to Choshu to defeat them. Also, the British and French retaliated against the Choshu clan for shelling foreign ships in Shimonoseki. The rest of the story will be told in the next article. In the next article, I will explain the movements of the Satsuma clan. Please subscribe to our channel and click the like button.